A lot of people should say, maybe the president is missing the point, that a lot of immigrants who come to this country from places within Africa are some of the most, you know, bright, educated men and women, like your own parents. Tell me about them.
Brooke, my parents immigrated to this country in the 1970s. They came with $300 in their pocket, and one thing they always instilled in my siblings and I is that America is where you can make it. Doesn't matter where you come from. If you work hard, if you study hard, if you face your studies, you can be anything in this country. Barack Obama proved to us that you can actually be president of the United States if you work hard. This is a sentiment that my parents believed in. You have no idea how invested immigrants are in the American dream. You have to be invested in that, to leave your country, leave all that you know and love, to come and try and make a better life for yourself and your future family here. That's what my parents did in the 70s. And Brooke, it worked out. Between my siblings and my husband, we have degrees from Wharton Business School, MIT, University of Virginia, American University, Yale, and the University of Virginia.
Ooh,
that's not bad. That's not bad at all. But guess what? We're not the anomaly. That is a norm for people in my set. That is a norm because there is an understanding that you are expected to achieve. You are given opportunity in America, and you're expected to make it. And again, I have numbers to back it up.
Yeah.
Nigerians make up less than 1% of the black population in the U.S. And yet, in 2013 alone, 25% of the black students at Harvard Business School were of Nigerian descent. Here's some more numbers for you, Brooke. Over a fourth of Nigerian Americans have a graduate or professional degree. Only 11% of whites in America can say the same. So we are model minorities. So this myth about Africans living in huts, being hungry with distended bellies, it's not a Sally Struthers commercial anymore. We are the most upwardly mobile people in this country.
Yeah.
Between Africans and the West Indians that I know, we make an extraordinary amount of money, we work extremely hard, and our goal is not only to be great citizens, but we want to make our parents, who sacrifice everything to give us quality educations and a better life, proud.
And the next generation.